Hello, this is Mia. In today's video, we will be unboxing the Lvbu KF30S Ebike Kit and walking through the full installation process. Whether you are a beginner or experienced, this guide will help you upgrade your bike effortlessly. Let's see what we are working with. Unboxing time first. In the kit, you've got the motor wheel, a boat battery, a controller, a thermal throttle, a charger, and a set of tools. Now let's go through the parts one by one. The first part is motor wheel. The motor power is 250 watts. And this is an off-road motor. You'll need a 100×10mm slotted dropout on your bike to mount it upright. It's built to fit all the popular sizes, 16 inches, 20 inches, 24 inches, 26 inches, 27.5 inches, 29 inches and 700C, and it plays nice with both disc brake and rear brake, so you are good to go with most bikes out there. It comes with an aluminum alloy rim that's both strong and lightweight, and is already fitted with a Kenda tire. Alright, now let's check out the battery. The KF30S kit comes with a bottle-style battery, packed with 30 cells inside. It's got a 9 amp-hour capacity and can take you up to 90 km on penta assist, which is a good choice for daily rides or weekend cruising. The battery weighs 1.82 kg. With a length of 280 mm and a diameter of 75 mm. The power switch and charging port are both located at the top of the battery. When you press the power switch, a ring of 10 green LED lights on the bottle head will light up. These LEDs also indicate the remaining battery level, so you can easily know when it's time to recharge. The charging port is a Type-C design. In addition to charging the battery itself, we also provide an adapter cable, so you can even use the KF battery to charge your phone. The battery casing uses a high-precision poldern coating finish, so it's not easily scratched. Plus, it comes in three color options, black, red, and blue. You can pick the vibe that fits your ride. The controller doubles as a bottle cage. It's super lightweight at just 0.4 kilograms. There's a keyhole at the bottom to lock the battery in place, keeping both the battery and controller secure and steady during riding, and it also helps prevent theft. The controller is integrated with the bottle battery, both mounted on the down tube frame. Both the battery and the controller come with an IP65 waterproof rating. You don't have to worry about riding in the rain. However, we recommend wiping off any water droplets on the motor, battery, and controller surface with a tissue after riding in the rain to prevent moisture from seeping in and damaging the components. Good maintenance like this can also help extend the lifespan of your gear. Next up are the accessories. This is the wild sambo strato. Which connects directly to the strato cable under the controller. Just press the strato and the motor kicks in instantly. In some European countries where stratos are not legal, you can skip installing this strato. A note remove the strato cable when ordering and will remove the strato cable for you. This is a Type-C charger. The AC plug comes in four types. US plug, UK plug, EU plug, and AU plug. Next is a disc brake rotor. We come standard with 160mm rotor. If you need 180mm rotors, please contact our customer service. And finally, you've got the basic installation tools and the manual to help you get everything set up. This is the standard packing list. If you need a Bluetooth display or a phone holder, you can check them out in our store or ask our customer service for help. Now let me show you how to get this kit installed. First, flip your bike upside down. This makes it easier to install the motor wheel. Next, line up the motor wheel with the slotted drop outs. Slide it in. Tighten up the bolts and washers on both sides. The side with the disc brake should be on the left when the bike's moving forward. Don't flip it the wrong way. left light, we'll need to spin the wheel and check if it's rolling smooth and if the brakes are working right. If the brakes fail off, you'll just need to give them a quick manual tweak yourself. Next step, we are gonna mount the battery holder onto the back frame. Most bikes have the two holes at this position, allowing you to mount the battery holder here. But no stress if your bike doesn't have those holes. You just need to buy a bottle cage adapter, and you are good to go. We'll plug the battery into the controller. And lock it in place to keep it steady and stop it from rattling around. And then we'll install the wild sample throttle. Use the matching installation tool to loosen the throttle's mounting screw. Then place the throttle on the handlebar and tighten the screw back up. Please make sure not to pinch or jam the throttle when installing it. Last step, connect all the cables. Then use some zip ties to secure them among the frame so the bike looks neat and tidy. It's very simple. Your bike is now fully upgraded. The bike keeps its original look and functions, but I did electric assist. Do you want to have a try?